Recession, man, I'm telling you, but God is awesome, man. You know, a lot of times when we say, God, use me, God, use me, God, please use me. Use me for your glory. But do we really want to be used by God? You got to really ask yourself.
That's right.
Come on.
Because if we had an interview with Hosea, could you imagine a conversation Hosea had with God? If you know the story, listen to me real fast.
Right.
I can see Hosea in his sandals and his robe walking back and forth. And he's like, God, what do you want me to say to the people? What do you want me to do for the people? God says, this is what I want you to do. I want you to marry Gomer. I tell you, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. You talking about who my boy's been with? Who my homie? She's the neighborhood. God's like, I want to use you to speak to the people about marriage. Hold on, God. Wait a minute, God. Wait. Can we not use Gomer? Can it be her sister? Or can it be? No, because she's never been with everybody. And could you imagine Hosea? Because the Bible says she kept going away.
Yeah.
Hosea was waking up and like, she's gone again. So he laced up his sandals and told the kids, I gotta go get your mama. He said, yeah, and I can see him on the road to Damascus. He's just walking like, God, I don't know how long I gotta do this. It's her third time this week. She ain't cooked. She ain't did nothing. And you told her, you wanna use me? You wanna use me? And I can see, she went some dude, and he looked at the dude, this is a big dude. He probably like, man. And God, I was like, I'll be like, God, he probably was like, God, can you give me strength to fight this dude? Can you hook a brother up, give me extra strength like Samson, and so I can fight this dude? God said, no, I want you to bypass him and go get your wife.
Wow.
How many of y'all want to be used by God now? Like, when the Bible says turn the other cheek,
yeah, right.
Let him hit me. Tell my God, tell my turn the other cheek. Pray for those who despitefully use you. Ooh, I am gonna pray for them. Matter of fact, I'm gonna reach out to them. I got a reach out ministry. Lord, help me. Oh God, help me not to strangle him. I know he talk bad about me, and I know he smile every time he see me. Lord, help me. Help me. Help me, God. I'm about to catch a case. You did say you would be a lawyer in the courtroom. You just want to hear somebody just because they talk crazy. I don't know, I got a violent spirit. But God has been great. So when we say we want to use us, you know what I mean? He does, God got a sense of humor. Look at your neighbor and say, God has a sense of humor. Okay, that, I did that wrong. Say, look at your neighbor and say, I know God has a sense of humor. Because look at you. Wonderful, man. Some of us on the fearful side, but that's okay. God looks at my heart. Because you know, growing up, mothers didn't mind telling you the truth. You ever just brought an interesting baby into the church and show the motherboard? And what she say? Oh, Jesus. Lord, have mercy. And then she say, bless your heart. You know that what that means. Bless your heart. I'm telling you, man, it's things go on, man. Is that Jesus?
Yeah, Jesus, the name,
Jesus is on. But you know, growing up, man, let me tell you. I've been doing comedy. The awesome thing is this is part of, but the awesome thing is I've been doing comedy right now for 8 years, and I had the the pleasure of opening up with Kirk Franklin. Amen.
Amen.
Well, kinda. He was on one side of town and I was on the other. In doing comedy, people always got jokes to give you, especially your family. And you just be nice and you just laugh. Like, knowing what I use in that joke. And so you be, people, hey, for sure, what's going on? Tell me a joke. Then I be like, I can't do that right now. And then I asked him, so what is your profession? I had one guy, he said, well, I'm a dentist. I said, well, can you work on my teeth right now? And he was like, no, I can't. I said, right, because you ain't in the plays. And I tell people, I'm a comedian. That's what God has blessed me to do. I don't know. I'm telling you, I get in the presence of God and God just be acting a fool with me. And I just share it with you. When people find out that I'm a, when I tell people I'm a preacher, they don't want me to preach no sermon.
There you go.
They want me to tell some jokes, but they don't want me to go, and God will. You ever just heard a preacher? He will. But I tell people, I'm crazy for God. I laugh at myself, man. But recession, a lot of things going on, man. And I'm just being real, because sometimes I still live in the flesh. Not the flesh, but the flesh. That's why I need to flush it down every day. I die daily. But I'm tired of these people. When I'm at the gas station, they come asking me for money. I'm tired. Don't ask me no more. I know you got $10 from something, don't ask me. So you know what I did? Instead of being violent, because I'm trying to get rid of the violent experience, you know what I do? I ask them first, before they ask me. And they'll be like, I was going to ask you. I was like, yeah, I got you. So I'm like, let me get 50 cents. They'll be like, I was going to ask you. I'll be like, yeah, So I had one brother, he came to the church. I go to Overcoming Church with Elder Bruce Farr. And he came to the church and he was like, well, y'all church folks, y'all get out of church and y'all don't want to help the homeless and stuff. I said, okay, bro, gotcha. I got you. I said, let me take you to Kroger's. So he was like, yeah. So one of my brothers of the church, he had a knife in his car. And he was like, Brother Martin, come here for me. So he handed me the knife. I was like, why are you handing me this knife? Because I don't care what he said. No, I don't want to hand me this knife. But I said, I'm going to take this knife. So he's sitting on the passenger side, right? And I got that knife in my hand. And I'm like, if he made one false move, I was like, oh. So I took him to Kroger's. That gentleman just wanted a honey bun and a soda. See, I said, I'm tired. No, so now, anytime somebody asks you for somebody, ask them first. You know what they're coming for. Don't you hate your family members that always ask you for money? You ever had that family member, they're coming over for Thanksgiving and you gotta lock up everything? Make sure, Junior, my door is locked. If Junebug walk by, you walk with him. He's not to be out the sight of no one. Be stealing your stuff and then try to sell it back to you. Got my initials on it. He's still, no, man, that's David Master. No, that's Donald Martin. It's crazy, man. Recession is going on. So a lot of things I just can't get no more like I used to get. And sometimes you have to just downsize in what you do.
Right.
So these nice Bibles, I can't get a nice Bible like I used to. Because a real good Bible costs you about $100.
Yep.
I mean, a real good one. They got all the translations, they got the concordance, they got everything, even got sermons in there for you. Mm. So I couldn't get that Bible. bootleg Bible. And I bought it from a Muslim. I bought a bootleg Bible from the Muslim. But it wasn't the King James Version. It was the Rick James Version. I should have known. And when they described Bathsheba, it said she was a brick house. I was like, oh, I know, I should. And then I went to Mark, it was just crazy. Missing Revelations. John 3:16 wasn't in there. So I'm trying to downsize, man. I'm trying to downsize. Don't, I'll tell you this, and this is the truth. Don't stop giving. I'm telling you. I work in the financial world. Let me explain something to you. I work in the financial world. I work in one of the most communities where it's in the top 10 in the nation as far as one of the richest communities. And when I work in the financial, in the corporate world, the most amazing thing I find out is people have a lot of things, but they don't have money. I have met with some of the high profile, and retired professional players that's making millions of dollars, but they can't get a $10,000 loan. What? Yeah. So, as I close,